Hey guys, so while I'm packing, I thought I would do, because I'm starting to pack all my purses and stuff, so I thought I would do a purse collection video for now, because that's something I've never showed you guys. So here goes. So this is in no specific order. I have this is my Mad Hatter bag. This has gotten really old, but this is my Johnny Depp bag. And I got this purse that's kind of like, looks like a bowling bag. A lot of people complimented on it and said it looked like a bowling bag. But it's actually a camera bag. When I looked it up, AcmeWear, my camera's not focusing, but anyway. It's a really cool, fun bag that I haven't used in a while, but I want to hold on to it. This is my bag that I take to church to carry my Bible in. Yeah, it's reversible. The inside has a stegosaurus that says vegetarian. I should say herbivore, but it says vegetarian. Yes, it's probably dragon in the background. I'm sorry if my music is too loud. Oh, it just stopped. Pandora's all messed up. Just a second. I'm just trying to figure this out. I have a whole bunch of stuff in here. Wallets and stuff. But I'm not going to go through that right now. Because I just went through it. So, I've had this one for a long time. I've gotten a lot of compliments on it. I got it at Kmart. It's almost like a messenger bag type. And it has a long strap, so I can just wear it over, you know, slinging over my shoulder. And I take this one a lot when I get tired of my other purses and I need to carry a lot. So I'm really trying to get things packed away and everything that's in the closet. Let's see. This purse I got in a thrift store. For $1.79, I looked it up. I customized it, obviously. But I looked it up, and it's something called Talbot. Gosh, it's hard to do this with one hand. I'm trying to show the label. It's hard to see Talbots. But anyway, it's a good purse for carrying books. You don't fit very much in it, but it's a really cute purse. And I work really hard on that. But it's actually a $200 purse. I was surprised. I'm not sure where I'm going to put that right now. So many things to do. I'm overwhelmed by the move all of a sudden. This purse I got from Annalise. That's such an awesome purse that she gave to me. And then most of my purses come from thrift stores. This one came from a thrift store. It's Karomi. It's just really cute. There's something in there. I feel like it's really heavy. Sometimes I wonder what I have in my purses. OB appointment stuff. Funny. Yeah. Breastfeeding. Anyway. Yeah, that's cool. That one can go back in the bag. And then I have this one that I made that you've seen before in old videos. It's a backpack bear. The bear came like this. It was a backpack, but I customized her. The dress is all messed up. Customized her. I haven't carried her in a long time, but I want to keep her because I work hard on her. And then I got this one at the thrift store, which I just can't part with because it's just too awesome. Even though I don't quite really like the purse because the strap's not long enough, but I really love Jack, so I'm keeping that one. I don't have as many purses as I used to, which makes me sad because I've had to downsize. This purse makes me really sad because it was a backpack and it was amazing. And I was able to use it a lot. But the straps started breaking, so I cut the straps off. And I'm going to try to do something with it. I can still carry it like this, but I don't want to get rid of it. I made that little bat patch and put it on there. And I made this little guy. So yeah. And then this is, let's see what's in here. Oh, clothes. And then this is my other bag that I got from a cool person on Instagram. Fit Girl, I forget, her name has another number to it, but this is cool. And I don't have, like I said, as many as I used to, which makes me sad, but what can you do when you're trying to downsize? And then lastly, this is my other one, Mason Grimm, whom I made. I got the bear, and it was a backpack, and it had a very small pouch, so I really customized it. I put extensions to make the straps fit me, because I think it was for a little kid. And then I took the zipper out and made this little button latch thing. And then I took a whole bunch of stuffing out and then made a lot more room in it. But everything else I just put together and made. I love his little hat, his little watch and stuff. But that's a tip, because a lot of the character backpacks are adorable, but they're not functional at all, because you can fit like what, one tiny wallet in there. But if you're willing to do the work, like what you need to do, I'll show you, is cut into the stuffing. I forget where I did it. Oh, probably right there where the stitches are. You cut into the stuffing and you pull out a bunch of stuffing so that it's not as thick, the animal or character is not as thick and plush, so you have way more room to stick stuff than normally. So that worked out really well for me. And I haven't used him in a long time either, but I'm definitely not parting with him because he's one of my pride and joys that I made. I love him very much. So that was my purse collection video, and oh, and of course my cycle purse. Cannot forget my cycle purse, which you guys have seen before. It's from my dear friend Shauna and Rob, and it's just an amazing purse, and I love it. This is the one I'm currently using, because I just, it fits so much, and I'm so happy with it. So anyway, that was my video, and again, please excuse the mess, I am moving. Thanks. Later.